this century will be a century about victory against disease, success in limiting pain and suffering, large-scale extension of life, and substantial augmentation of human capability. And it's probably going to be the best thing that ever happened to mankind.
Even the breakthroughs in immunology that you've heard about and immuno-oncology were really made possible by basic scientists, including scientists like Gordon Freeman and Lee Nadler at the Dana-Farber, who were simply trying to understand the rules in terms of how the immune system works.
You know, the opportunity to work at Dana-Farber and collaborate, you know, with all the disease experts really opened my eyes to, you know, the real impact that academic drug discovery can have on patient care.
Dana-Farber is, in fact, the premier place for science discovery. What makes us very special, and the colleagues are just awesome, is that we can take these discoveries and make them count for patients.
So this institution, Dana-Farber, is one of our go-to phase 1 sites for our new drugs. And it's critically important because the physicians here and at other major academic centers are the ones who are going to really know and get the feel for, is our drug helping patients? Is it effective? Is it safe? How should we use it? We can't do that within the walls of industry. That has to be done here.
Because if you take this as the concept of an ecosystem, what it means is that if any individual part of the ecosystem gets damaged, the whole thing grinds to a halt. And the next 20 years can be even brighter because the science has never been better.
I think our goal at Dana-Farber is to do first-in-human clinical trials of molecules that we have developed in-house.
There's a huge opportunity for centers like Dana-Farber to not just participate, but to lead in therapeutic discovery science. I think there's a huge opportunity. I mean it when I say, Dana-Farber has quietly assembled the best chemical biology department in the world, the most translational chemical biology department in the world.
The most important thing that a philanthropist can do is set off a chain that leads to an extraordinary discovery.